Hello. Thank you for joining us today for the 2020 IEEE Women in Engineering and Women in Radio Science event. Perhaps we should call this Women Who Make Waves. I'm Dr. Cynthia Furse from the University of Utah, and I wanted to talk a bit today about the power of change. So please let me introduce myself in the way I think of myself. I am a professor and a scholar. I am a teacher. I am an engineer, an inventor. I am a business person, an entrepreneur. But most of all, I think of myself as a wife, a mom, and a grandma. This is how the world sees me. But this is how I see myself. And I hope all of us have people in our lives who are so important that we want to make the world's most important changes. So let's talk a bit about change. We know something about change. It's a gradient or a slope. If we are headed up the mountain, that might be wonderful, hiking to get a fabulous view, or it might just be exhausting. On the way down, that could be exhilarating, like skiing, or it could be terrifying, like falling. Change is a powerful thing, whether we are going up or whether we are coming down. The power of that change is how we use it. We know a lot about change in electromagnetics. We know about Maxwell's equations and the importance of the time-varying electromagnetic fields. If the fields don't vary with time, if they don't change, then they are static and they stay on the board and we don't get all the magic of electromagnetics. It is that time variance that is so important to us and that makes the fields do all the things that we're excited about. So let's talk about change. There are two mathematical terms that we use. We use a delta very often to represent change. It looks like a mountain. We use a gradient term. That looks like a valley. So whether we're talking about change that is going to the top or change that's coming to the valley, both of those are important changes that we already know about. So when we are choosing change, when we are choosing that change that we want to make, choose something important. Work on the most pressing problems of your day. Choose something that's big enough to warrant your energy, and choose something that you care deeply about. Mahatma Gandhi said, "Be the change that you want to see in the world." So I want you to take just a minute and think about a change that you are facing. It might be a change in your work. It might be a change in your career. It might be a change in your family. It might be a change that you want, and it might be one you don't. So think for a minute about an important change that you are facing. Okay, so now, keep your change in mind as we talk today. Now, with your change, it's time to innovate. It's time to come up with a fabulous idea, have the light bulb turn on, and come up with an idea that's going to solve your change, right? Well, not quite so fast. Albert Einstein has said, "We cannot solve our problems with the same thinking we used when we created them." We need a different perspective. We need to think outside the bowl. This is my cat. He's trying to get the goldfish, but he's blocked by the stair railing. So first he patted the bowl from the left and the right and the top. He tried to reach over the top, and then he turned himself over to get a different perspective. Now, did the cat get the fish? You can see they're not even afraid of him. No, this cat never got the fish, but he sure tried hard. Sometimes in our careers, we face problems that need a change of perspective. An example of one of mine was finding faults on aircraft wiring, the types of faults that cause fire and loss of control and disasters, such as TWA 800 and Swissair 111. We tried so many different ways of finding these faults in the time domain and the frequency domain, but many of those didn't work very well until we had a change of perspective and realized that those faults were happening in flight, not on the ground where we were looking for them. It wasn't an instant fix. There wasn't a way to find faults in flight, but it led to the development of spread-spectrum time-domain reflectometry that we use today to find faults on live electrical wires. Now think again about your change. Think about how it feels. Do you feel fear, exhilaration, excitement, questioning? Often acknowledging the feelings that you have about a change are very important to moving forward to exhilarating and exciting opportunities and the best solutions. Very often, it's important to escape your comfort zone. Most of us feel a certain amount of fear or discomfort when facing a major change. This is an example of some of our research in Antarctica. I'm the one down at the bottom, and I can promise you I'm out of my comfort zone, way out of my comfort zone. But working on that tremendous research project led me to my own mountain. This is Mount Erebus. It is a volcano in the middle of Antarctica, and it's putting out little bits of steam. You can see it there. Working in the shadow of Mount Erebus was a truly magical experience, and it wouldn't have happened without stepping way away from my comfort zone. I didn't consider myself particularly brave, but what I learned was to dare. Dare to try it. Dare to fail. We failed many times, but dare to succeed. So escaping my comfort zone and taking a little bit more daring led to some tremendous research opportunities. So I have to encourage you to step out of that comfort zone. It's okay. Now, this is what innovation and change really looks like. It's not a straight line. It's not neat and tidy. It doesn't work the way we planned it. Innovation is messy. And we may encounter many defeats, but we must not be defeated. Let me give you an example of perseverance. This is my friend Monica. Monica ran for Sandy City Council. She worked for months canvassing the neighborhood, making phone calls and visits, social media, talking to people. She worked for months to become a Sandy City Councilwoman. And this is how the vote stood on that fateful day. Now, how did Monica feel? Did she feel like she had succeeded because she got 49.7% of the votes? Or did she feel like she failed because her competitor got 50.3%? How do you think she felt? But as all the votes were counted and all the mail-in ballots came in, let me introduce Monica Zoltansky, Sandy City Councilwoman, a woman for change. Very often, the answers, the votes, and the solutions have not come in until after the voting day. So it's very important to stick with it, keep the perseverance, and plan for success. Now there's another thing about change. Change really isn't a solo activity. Do it together. Build alliances. People don't always agree with you. In fact, many people will probably naysay your best ideas, but build alliances with those who have the biggest problems and want the biggest solutions and are willing to work with you. Build alliances, create a community, and don't be afraid to lead, and don't be afraid to follow. I know this picture is upside down. This is a picture of my flipped classroom. In 2007, I started teaching in a totally different way. It didn't have a name. I recorded my lectures on video, had the students watch them before they come to class, so that I had that whole hour to be able to work with problems and solve problems with them, and it just created a much more engaging and exciting classroom. And that was great for my class, but how do you think the flipped classroom became something bigger than me? Bigger than even electromagnetics. It's used extensively throughout the world today. That came from building alliances and a community and helping everyone succeed in this kind of teaching. It wasn't something solo. This was a together project. Now let's go back to your change. Think about what you know and think about what you don't know. What puzzles you about this change? What don't you know yet? So rather then letting that uncertainty of the things we don't know, instead of letting uncertainty derail our progress toward change, instead we need ways to plan for that uncertainty as we move forward. Now, most of us are used to coming up with a plan A, a plan B, a plan C, putting them into the mix and seeing how it goes. But think about this in more detail. You don't need just a plan A, B, and C. Go D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Plan in the short term and the medium term and the long term. The important thing is to continually assess how your plans are going and not to be afraid to adjust them and adapt. Because if we put all of these plans into practice, we can often end up with something that's much more magical than what we started out with in the first place. An example of this in my own work of adapting, I'll fall back on the aircraft wire example again. So that was designed for airplanes, but this is what happened last week. It was approved for work on network rail, trains. So technology that was originally designed for flight works equally well for trains that are moving around. So the ability to adapt is tremendously powerful. Today, the world does need powerful change. We do have a global pandemic. We do have climate change and global warming. We do have bias and prejudice against many people in the world around us. The world needs changes. It needs us to reach for those changes. So think about your change and make it powerful. Thank you for joining me today, and I look forward to seeing and hearing about your change as it moves through the future. Thank you very much.